I mean, I just trusted what the advice from Mac and my agent. I mean, my agent's been around a while and knows what he's doing. So he's the one talking to NBA team. So if he says, I think you need to go back to school and work on some things and be in a better spot next year, then I'm going to listen to him. But the other part of that was just spending a full summer, because I haven't had a full summer in college yet, to actually get better and work on my body. So I think it's been really beneficial and it's been really worth it to do that.
What did they say that maybe it would be beneficial to you, areas of improvement for you?
Honestly, it was nothing like drastic, nothing like one glaring hole in my game. I mean, just getting a little better shape, get a little stronger, shoot the ball a little better, be a little tougher, things like that, but nothing like, you suck at this, you need to get better at that. But so it was just little improvements in a few different areas.
I've seen you evolve, you know, not just on the court but off. Like, you get on guys, you're more vocal. Is that comfortable for you, or is that a process for you to become more of that older, loud leader guy?
I'd say that's definitely a process. That's not my, I'm not like a natural leader in that way, but, you know, when you get to being in college for 15 years, you kind of see yourself in a leadership role by the end. So I've kind of tried to step into that a little bit and try to lead my team. I mean, obviously I'm not the only leader on the team. All the guys are pretty good leaders in their own right. But yeah, I've been trying my best to be a leader.
It wasn't a difficult deal? Like, did somebody say, hey, we got to get you more vocal or whatever? Or did you just kind of know?
I don't know. Mac's been on me about that since my sophomore year. He knows that's not like, not how I naturally am, but he saw the importance of if I'm more vocal, then we'd be better off as a team. So I think I'm finally getting there since my sophomore year.
So you got married.
That was awesome.
This summer?
It was in August, yeah. It was awesome. It went perfect. Couldn't have asked for a better day.
I saw a lot of fellas there. What was that like? Because I haven't been married before, married myself. It's kind of weird because you see everybody on all these walks of life. It was emotional, whatever. What was that day like for you looking back at it?
I mean, it was amazing. It was, I think, one of the most special things for me and Rachel was just that everyone that we love and loved us was there. And it was really cool because, like, some of it was our teammates, some of it was our family, extended family, some of it was, like, high school friends, and they were all there at the same time, like, getting to meet each other and see them all in one place. It was just so amazing.
Was it here?
It was in Iowa City, where Rachel's from.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool. It's got to be nice, too, to bounce stuff off Steven, because obviously he's been through, done that. I mean, is it nice to have a resource like Steven that you haven't gone through yet?
Yeah, it's definitely nice to have another guy in the same stage of life as you on team. But I don't think I've needed too much advice yet, but it is nice that he's there if I need it.
Right, pick your battles. That's my advice.
Yeah.
What about the new guys? Like, obviously you lose Baylor, you lose Trey. I mean, there's going to be the Floyd and Bello. Who do you see, like, stepping up in some of those roles, and who could really make a splash this year, some of the newcomers that maybe fans, you know, average fans, may not know too much about?
I mean, I think two of our transfers, Pop and Jemiah, are going to be amazing. Someone asked me about this the other day, and I was like, I don't want them to come in and try to be Baylor and Trey. I want them to come in and try to be themselves, even though they're taking Baylor's and Trey's role. But those two players are great in their own right, and they're going to do their own thing, Pop and Jemiah, and they're going to do an amazing job. But I think someone from within the program that's going to be really, really good this year is Jason Green. I think he's going to take off and be so much better than was like. He was really good last year, but I think he improved a lot. So I'm really excited for all three of those guys and how they're going to help this team.
Obviously, the expectations are always there for great, no matter who you leave and who you lose and who comes in.
Mm-hmm.
How would you write the script for your final season in college to how this goes? I mean, what's the goal? How would you like this season to go?
I mean, I'm honestly just been trying to keep it simple, like take it in one day at a time, try to get better every single day. For every single game, just take it one game at a time, try to attack that one game and try to win as many games as possible. I mean, obviously this is my last year, so I want to take it in and not really miss anything by looking too far ahead. So I don't know if I want to say there's any, like, one defined goal. I just want to get better every day and win as many games as possible.
Isn't it hard, though, to convey that to the young guys who see the NCAA tournament? March Madness, we want to get to the Final Four. We want to win a national championship. How do you take this? Hey, young buck, we got to get through Purdue first.
I mean, yeah, it's hard. I remember, like, looking back on my freshman, sophomore year when I was younger, you just It's how you are when you're 18, 19 years old. You look ahead, you get really excited for it, and it's really understandable. Like, playing in March Madness is a lot of fun and something you'll remember forever, but I mean, the key to getting there and being successful there is getting better now and learning from the games in November and December. So, I mean, you just try to lead by example in that area and just say, like, hey, like, let's not try to just get through this practice today. Let's get better in this practice.
Two more. One, you're mentioned on this list with some of the greats of all time in the Big East, some of the big men that you're listed with, the Ewings and the Mullins. It's just a tumble. A, what does that make you feel like? And B, what would you like to be remembered in terms of being in the same conversation as some of those all-time
players? It's kind of crazy because, you know, I don't think it's really sunk in yet. I don't think it'll sink in until after I'm done playing that people have talked about me in the same conversation as those guys. Because I'm thinking about those guys, and I'm like, those are all-time greats. Like, I'm not in that conversation. But, yeah, it's definitely an honor to be in those, but it really hasn't sunk in yet. But I think at the end of the day, when my career is over, I want people to just remember me like, I don't know, like, I obviously want to win games, so I want them to remember me as a winner. I want them to remember that I did it the right way, I handled myself the right way on and off the court, and I just represented Creighton the right way. I think that's what I want to be remembered for.
That's awesome. That's great. All right, last one. Do you have a hidden talent? Like, what the heck are you good? Like, what were you good at as a kid other than basketball?
As a kid, I don't know, I played like every sport when I was little, and I like to think I was pretty good at all the sports I played, but I don't know, I'd say now a hidden talent, at least something I can do that a lot of people don't know, is I can play guitar decently, so I think that's one thing not as many people know I can do.
Acoustic?
Yeah, I love acoustic.
What's your go-to song? Do you have a song you play?
One of the ones I learned early on was Landslide by Fleetwood Mac, so that's one of my go-to ones that I love playing.
Does Rachel sing?
No, she doesn't. She likes... I can't sing either, though, so she's actually a pretty good singer. She just doesn't like singing in front of me, so.
Is there a young guy on here that we should know something about what they can do?
Man, if you asked me before this, I would have sat down and think about it, but I can't pull anything off the top of my head.
Yeah, so they were saying Jason Green's kind of a DJ.
Jason actually is super talented, like super creative guy. He is a DJ. He makes beats, so.
Amazing.
Yeah.
I think that's
a good one.
Oh, look at Andy. Yeah. In the media guide, it says the NIL deal you want is with Bass Pro.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Give Andy a sales pitch on
why you
should engage.
Why are you, Mr.
Bass Pro, if you hear this, please give me an NIL deal. I love fishing. I love outdoors, camping, all that. I'll do an Instagram post, whatever you guys need.
You could be a big and tall guy.
Yeah, I mean, you need a big and tall guy, I'm your guy, man.